On this trip, I'm gone for a total of 4 days. 2 days in Switzerland, 2 days of travel, and shooting 4 episodes. It's definitely not the most chill travel schedule. One project that I'm investigating is Cubli. When you first see Cubli move, it's a little eerie. But when you start to understand the physics, it's just plain cool. This is Gaja, one of Cubli's creators.
What if you want to make the Cubli jump all the way? So here the problem is the torque from the motors is not sufficient. Then you see these brakes here. These are typical bicycle brakes. And these brakes are actuated by these servo motors. So they have an elliptical head. And when you rotate it, they squeeze the brake in. Mm-hmm. It's a simple mechanism to suddenly brake. So there are accelerometers and gyroscopes. So very small gyroscopes and accelerometers. So if I'm pushing, the sensors are detecting that the Cubli is moving away from the equilibrium position. It's similar to us humans, when we are standing there and if we are falling, we make the hands like this to counteract. So it's an exact thing happening here.
Understanding how to balance the inverted pendulum led to the Segway. Developing the controls in Cubli could lead to a whole new breed of robotics. And take a look at an earlier version of Cubli.
So at first it needs a little bit of help to stabilize around the balance point. So each of the arms is measuring the angle of the arm, the acceleration from which it can determine the direction of gravity, so which way is down, and the rate of rotation. These measurements are then shared across a network, and all of the arms will then react to balance the frame upon its corner.
So this is the first Cubli that we built. So you can see when we do prototypes, we quickly, so this is the board, the computing board, and you can buy it like for $17, this thing. And you can see all the quick prototype things, and we showed that it can balance. So even before that was this guy.
Oh, this is just a test.
Just a test bed, you can test the 1D prototype. Though. So this is the motor that was hidden behind all these wirings before.
Yeah, it is.
From the babies, we constantly keep on learning and adapt to situations, and that's what we are trying to give it to the machines.
What do you think? Is developing more sophisticated robotics a good idea? Are we headed towards the end of humans or to a more thriving society? Let me know in the comments. Click subscribe so you don't miss the next episode.